Hello? Hello. Hi everybody. Oh, this is good. The mic is good. Yep, so I think it's time. It's 12:05, we need to start. So I'm here talking about automating Drupal migration. So let's get started. So this presentation was actually created by a few of my colleagues, and I also was on top of them. So this was actually need to be presented by Nupal, but she is not there right now with me. And also Nishad, he is also there in India. So I'm representing both of them. And I'm Nikhil here, senior Drupal architect working in 5G solutions. I'm having more than 16, 17 year experience in IT. And for last 8.5 years, I'm working in Drupal. So, let's talk about the topics today. So there will be some facts and dates which we need to talk about. What the solution, how to do migration, why not we do migration from D6 to D8, why not? Migration versus automated migration and a script which we have created for it. Example use cases, the sneak peek for the script, and then we'll talk about the question and answer series. So let's talk about some facts and dates before we start and drill into migration strategy. So Drupal 8 released on November 19, 2015. Happy baby. Then February 24, 2016, Drupal 6 reached end of life and no longer supported. Sad baby. So I think how many people will be still working in day 6? Few of the people from this room may be working in day 6. Wow, it's good to know that. So you can see the links here in the down, D8 release date, when it happened, and D6 EOL. So we have referred from there. So what happens? How it implies to my site if it ends, the D6 is ending. So you will not have any new projects or module for D6. You will not have bug fixing the existing sites, no updates in the documents, no core commits will be there, no support or security advisors, though it was written in the last day slide that there will be some security updates may be possible, but I'm still confused how it will happen. And in the future, the update status may stop working also. These are some facts for D6, why we should migrate to any other version than D6, because already end of life now. So this is being taken yesterday. So this is the link in which you can see how many projects are using Drupal, and you can see the D6 there. So D6, as highlighted in yellow, there are 117,307 sites still using D6 till yesterday. This screenshot is taken yesterday from the live Drupal.org site. So we still have lots of people who are using D6. And think about the people who are using D7. It's maybe double of that. And think about the people who have started using D8. Lots of numbers that started using D8, 67,000. It's a good number for D8. So what's the solution? The solution is migration from D6 to D7. Yeah, we can argue why we can't do D6 to D8, but let's talk about why we have to migrate to D6 to D7 first. So why not D6 to D8? Well, there are a few things more which need to be done in D8, like node types, they're still not available from D6 to D8. Fields are missing on the edit form on the view page. Files and images, how we need to migrate for D6 to D8. URL aliases, there is no standard module for migration for views, which is available in D6, my existing D6 site, to D8 directly. There is no module right now available for menu UI for migrating from D6 to D8 directly. And there are a few other modules like contributed modules that you already know we are still porting in D8. So D6 have still a bunch of modules which are available, and they are still not there in D8 for us. So let's talk about migration versus automated migration. So what happens in migration? So lots of people actually talk about when we actually get a project from any client, they say, I have a D6 side, can you make it in D7? And I want the same look and feel. I want everything exactly the same as D6. The only thing what you require is that you need to have in D7. Now, when we talk about migration, we always think about content migration. People will keep on talking to me about migrate module, how your data from one particular database will be migrated to D7 or D8, whatever. But there are other manual steps which we need to take when we do migration. It's not only data. You have to lot of other things also when we have to do migration from one base version of D6 or to D7. For example, we need to take backups. Those are very, very small things, but we need to do it. We have to upgrade to D6 latest version. We have to set up a new D7 site. We have to compare the list of all the modules available in one D6 site, and those contributed modules are available in D7 or not. And this need to be done by us so that we can have exactly the same functionality which is required for D7 from D6. So what automated migration will do? What we are trying to achieve here is that we will have a script which actually automate the maximum possible scenarios for migration. So we are not saying that I'm going to migrate your entire site in a poof, and I will just run the script and voila, you have a D7 site ready and working perfectly. What I'm saying is that the manual steps what generally people have to take for migration, that need to be automated and that can be automated. So those kind of steps we are actually trying to automate and make it more streamlined. For example, the most common manual step need to be followed for D6 type sites can be automated for D7. So let's talk about automated migration here. This is what involves. So if you see here, we have to start a migration. We have to take a backup of the database of Drupal. Then we have to check the module on module status for D7, because we are starting from D6. Then we have to upgrade the existing site. If your D6 is not being updated to the latest D6, we have to update that. Then we have to take the site offline, then change the theme to Garland, disable all non-core modules, delete all the other files and folders except sites, remove default settings.php, remove unwanted modules, check all optional modules checkboxes, download and extract D7, reapply changes of htaccess in robots.txt, make settings file writable, run update.php, enable the modules, download the new module on site on modules, remove old modules, backup your database, run update.php on D7, upload D7 compatible theme, check status report, set update fees access equal to false, you know that already why we do it, remove maintenance mode, end of migration. Now this is not I'm talking about content migration. These are the steps which are required when you actually have to do migration from a D6 site to a D7 site. So my content migration is one aspect, and you have an existing D6 site, you have to migrate to another D7 site or D7 site, how you will do it. These are the steps involved for it. So for example, use case, let's take a scenario here. We have a content based site. Your site has events, programs, display informations, okay, all content are based on location, and your user come and visit the site for content, anonymous user site, there's no authenticated users on top of it. So what the solution will be, the script which we have developed will actually do all these steps and will actually handle your migration accordingly, because this is a very, very small site, has only anonymous content, no other complexity is involved. Our script will actually take up the entire D6, latest D6, take all the steps which I have just showed you in the previous slide and do the migration accordingly, or put that to have a D7 site working accordingly. Multilingual, multi-international site. So I have a content where it's coming from different languages or multilingual, your site viewers come from within the site, and you can select the preferred language if you want to view the site. In that scenario also we can use this script. So this script will actually take your D6 site, upgrade it to the latest version to D7, and then you can use it. So to be very honest, as I told you already, the script is not like a magic. It actually does the manual step what is required for D6 to D7. And once it is done, if any kind of issues are available in your D7 site, you still have to resolve. But the manual step what is required to do the entire process is actually being automated here. So let's see the demo, how it works. So sorry, this is the screen. So I'm actually giving you a video how it is being done. So this is our script, D6 to D7, copy.sh. We are actually asking that what is your current environment, what is your which particular D7 site you want to do, and what will be the alias for it. So this particular script is using combination of Drush commands as well as shell script. So it's actually doing lot of things in the background. It actually running a shell script, which will actually do the part of what kind of contributed modules are available in D6, what kind of custom modules are available in D6, putting in a TXT file, and then it is actually manipulating from there. So first thing what it did is actually, if you see it, it actually first updated and check what is the latest version right now. So there is no updated version required for Drupal currently, that the time the script was executed. So it actually found that there is no Drupal core update required for it. So it actually worked and just said no code updates right now. So this is what is being written, that is already up to date. So Drupal, no code is updated for now, it's already working. Then the cache is cleared, and then a Drush command is executed with actually asking for whether you want to update it from D6 to D7. And then the entire process will start. Now this particular line for custom.txt, this is a particular thing which we are actually doing it for in the shell script, where we actually find that whether your D6 site is already having any custom modules. To find this is a very simple way. If you have a standard D6 site, there will be a custom folder within the modules folder. We'll try to find out and see whether any custom modules are available there. We create a TXT file on top of it so that when we are migrating to D7, we'll get all those custom files, custom modules, and we will run coder upgrade on top of it. There is a module in Drupal known as Coder Upgrade, which actually runs your D6 module to D7. It tries to convert it to a particular extent. And that's what we will try once we have the site done. So this is a standard Drush command, which is actually asking for various things, like what your site exists, where the destination, and we have to just keep on doing that. It will gather the information for your core and contributed modules. So it's all the part of your Drush command itself, which actually doing right now. So let me skip to a bit so that you can actually, because this is just a Drush command which is updating the site. So here you go, it actually run the site and gave you the links, the update command also ran here. And you can see that it's keep on updating all the nodes and everything. Sorry guys, this is huge. Yep. So once it is done, it will finish all the updates, and then it will actually ask for the, there's 15 steps you can see to start replacing the non-core modules and all. And there also we will actually do that. And then we will do run update.php on D7. Sorry, I think I need to start again. So once it does the drush command, it actually has few more steps. I just wanted to show you that. So here what happens once the command is executed, it actually also look at the modules which are available in your contributed list. So what happens is here in your, there will be three files will be created actually. One is for custom and one is for contrib and one is for, you know, for the themes. So if in the contrib.txt, whatever we have created from the shell script, if there is a list of modules which need to be there for D7, it is our script will automatically start downloading those. So here what happens is that, for example, in our txt file, there was a module for CCK, generally not required for D7, but if it is there, it will start downloading it and enable it by default in your D7 side. And then once it is enabled, then it will start, you know, implementing that. It will check for database update, it will check for any kind of further fields or something is required on the site. If it is there, then it will update those. So here what happens, automatically then a D7 folder is created, which is actually your site. It will be available in your folder itself. So it will actually create a destination folder for D7. And here you see it has got all the files and everything. So this folder was not there previously. Because of the script, it's got created. And then if I go, I will see in settings.php, and I will see that all the files are there. And this is my D7 site which is being just created from the script. And if I go to administration, I can see that in the reports it is being given from the latest Drupal 7 site. So it is now updated to Drupal 7 site, which is latest, and it has all the code and everything as available in D6 based on the contributed models which are already available there. So this is what the script does. So it has the latest version of Drupal 7, and it is being created from the scratch using the script from D6 to D7. Also, it has also migrated the theme. So one particular theme which is there in D6, it is being migrated to D7. And if you enable the theme, it also works the way it should be. So this is what happens when you run the script. And it will actually take up you and give you all the things required for D7 site. So it's actually, we can see that how we can add the functionality and all. So he's actually trying to click all the links and see everything is working fine in DA7 perspective. So once it is done, it will be done. So this is the site which actually does via the script. So how it helps us with respect to D6 to D7? The way it helps is that whenever a client will ask for a D6 to D7 migration, along with the migrate module, which we can generally use for the content migration, the manual steps which are required for the migration can be automated in such a way. So the estimated time which you require for the migration from D6 to D7 reduces, because there are a lot of manual efforts which are required to do that migration reduces. So you can actually use this kind of script, which actually does the combination of shell command as well as the Drupal Drush commands. And based on that, the script is being created in such a manner so that at least 20 to 30% of your estimation reduces because of the manual things what we need to do in the background. The content migration, anyway, we know that we have a very good migration module available in the D8 now, which we can use, or we can use the D6 to D7 module. The question can be asked that what we will do about the custom modules. So the answer is that custom modules can be auto-migrated using coder upgrade to a little extent, but you can't do it very much full 100% for the custom migration. For the custom modules, you can actually do a bit, and then you can actually do manual entries if you require to do for the functionality. So this is what the script does, and this is what the script is all about for D6 to D7 migration. We are also working on the similar grounds for the script for D7 to D8 or D6 to D8. But the only thing is, based on the migrate module currently available, we'll actually add all these manual entries there, and then we'll start working in that direction. So yeah, this is it. This is what automated migration is all about. Any questions?
The public to download?
Not right now, but yeah, it can be available. So because our thinking was that we are actually getting a lot of requests that we have a D6 site, please migrate to D7 or D8. When we said about D8, they said that D8 is still unstable. I mean, the country model is still in the porting. So can we have a D7 first, and then we can go for a D8 one? So because of all the requests, we actually started creating a script like this. So when we get a request, we run the script, and then we can do the migration. So yeah, it will be available. Yeah. Any other question?
So can you clarify the time scale for that in weeks, months?
Which one?
The current script that you've just shown.
Yeah.
Which you said you'll make available.
Yeah, so we need to do some bit of housekeeping in that left. Once it is done, I think in a few weeks it will be available. So that can be done, that's not a problem. But yeah, we are also working on D8 script so that we can actually do the migration from D6 to D8 clearly, rather than only go for D7. So that's our main objective. Any other question? Well, thank you.